Our next storyteller hosts precisely 27 comedy shows around the Detroit area. Just to name a couple, he hosts The Comfort Zone, which is a storytelling night like this. It happens at Trixie's in Hamtramck. And next week, he's hosting a show called Netflix Special at Jean's Vintage in Hamtramck. Please welcome Jason Brent.
Thank you, guys. So nice of you. I tested my I'm going to talk about in winter on Tuesday, and as I told a group of people that I admire, people who don't notice anything, people in winter got really offended by that. So I was like, I'm right, because you guys didn't notice. That's not, like, it's not an insult to not notice anything. You guys you have a much easier time if you don't notice every single thing happening all the time. You're not prone to oversharing. You're not going to start the topic off with, I was just in Chicago for a funeral, and boy, is my aunt still dead. Spike hips, there's a funeral, you know, you just go, then you go home, maybe you fix that. It. No, I couldn't do that. I was like, this is my aunt's second funeral. I'm the only one in the family that's noticed that. There's a Baptist service. First one was Catholic, so that first one was boring. It's Baptist funeral. It's like, we're all just celebrating the life of a person. There's a choir, and they're so good and like powerful that their voices are rattling the walls. No instruments are going, just voices. I'm like, this is amazing. Then they went to Catholic one, like, at this point, we'd just be kneeling again, and no one would show up. So, of course, my aunt had to die first to get two funerals. My dad gave me a call one day. He said, we gotta go to Chicago to give the hospital permission to take her off life support. And I was just like, did you notice that there's really not much paperwork to do that? He did. It's really just a couple lines on some pages. It's like, you want to come do this? And I'm like, I'd love to experience it, sure. We finally get to the hospital. I'm like, this is the Catholic hospital, so now I'm imagining this paperwork's getting filed in a cabinet where miracles aren't real. We step out of the elevator to the floor my aunt was on the first time. I was the only one that noticed it. It just said, shh, people are healing. And I was like, well, not everybody, right? We gave the doctors the miracles aren't real paperwork. They had to work like unhooking the life support stuff, and I was also the only one who noticed that when you're watching that happen to someone you love or just someone you know in general, you really just expect them to just die. That's what movies are like, and that's a way better way to do it, because what actually happened. Now it's just me and my dad and some relatives we haven't really seen since the 90s. Just trying to have that normal hospital visit while not making it obvious that we're just watching her chest go up and down just to see if it's gonna keep going. It did. When you're in the room like that, the doctors still have to come in and out, pushing buttons. And you know, they normally tell you what the buttons do and how it's gonna help. I swear they just shrugged as they were leaving the room at this point. Finally, one of them was like, do you guys need anything? And we all just looked at each other. I was like, well, I guess we could like use some more things to talk about. How about that? I had like seven more times of that. I was like, hey, can you just like tell us how much longer this is going to be? Because we've only got the hotel for one night, and if we have to take Monday off, we will. But no one knows how to phrase that question because we're all trying not to look like horrible people. Eventually we just called it ourselves. We're like, it's been 36 hours. This is clearly not happening. She's just asleep, snoring on drugs, like she doesn't even notice that we left. I'd like to say there's an ending to that part of the story, but there really isn't, because we just went home and like 6 days went by and we got a phone call. We're like, oh, all right. We didn't do funeral number one right away. We had to do my dad's wedding first. Nice dichotomy going there. My new step family's great. They're people who don't notice things. Wedding happens, we're at the reception, my new stepsister walks up to me. She's like, isn't it weird to get a stepsister in your 30s? I was like, no, because maybe you should have noticed that our parents dated for 3 years and we don't hang out, so nothing changed for you and me today. I thought it would be weird if she asked me to watch her kids now and my label's stepbrother instead of, I think that's the son of the guy my mom's dating. The very next day was funeral number one, and yeah, I'm not gonna go in again, how boring it was. I did notice at the funeral that my godmother said, you should help your dad get back to church more. I'm like, you're my godmother. Our relationship doesn't work that way. Because I don't go either unless you're in town. Or there's a funeral. Now we're planning a third funeral, and I'm the only one in my family that's noticed that so far. And we didn't even like this animal. The last time we saw her, like, alive was, like, 6 months before this, at her husband's funeral, and then before that, 4 years, at my mom's funeral. And before that, I was like, I don't know. 92? I don't know. It's fun part of my life right now, realizing that the only reason we get together anymore is because someone died. Because when I was little, the only whole point of getting together was to hang out with grandma. And then we ran out of grandmas and we stopped hanging out. Thank you very much.